Hey folks, how are you guys doing? Hope you are all having a great day so far and a great beginning of your work week. It's an absolutely beautiful day here. It's been the past couple days just gorgeous. It's the beginning of March and it's 75 degrees outside and it's just beautiful. Low humidity and I'm loving it right now. We've had a really, 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 really mild winter this year. Didn't really even have a winter. So that means this summer is probably going to be brutal, and also means, as you may have saw in my last Tool Talk video, that none of the mosquitoes got killed off or whatever, so from the cold. So mosquitoes are probably going to kick my butt this year. But anyway, last project that I made was a collaboration with Sean Stone. He brought over a couple of furnace blower motors, and there's another one right there, and I'm going to make a filter unit for my shop here soon. Just not going to record it though, because we already recorded one when I made his video. Or his project. So, speak of the devil, there's mosquitoes. I just went blank. Mosquitoes, filter. Yes, the filter. I'm going to make a filter for my shop. Probably won't record it because we already did that. And I have been kind of filtering the air, not with an actual dedicated shop filter, but with my dust collector. Normally when I run my machines, I leave the dust collector running for 10-15 minutes afterwards and just randomly turn it on with the ports open to kind of clean the air as best as possible. It's got a canister filter on it, so that whatever filtration that is, it's better than nothing. And I like to keep the door open when possible to kind of circulate air as well. But I've gotten to where I don't like to record with the door open as much, because the lighting changes the color, and this particular camera is very finicky on colors. And I finally got it to where I think I've got the color profile set up to where I don't have to mess with it in video editing. But anyway, yeah, that was the last project. We did 3 filters on the intake side, 1 filter on the exhaust side. Why? I don't know. It's just more filters the better. Oops. More filters the better, I guess. And as you can see, what I just knocked down, this is 4-quarter Hickory. It's 61 1/4 board feet, and I got this for my dining table build that I'm about to do. And I've really been kind of pulling my hair out with this design on this table, just flip-flopping back and forth. I don't know why, but I am extremely indecisive on this particular project. I originally came up with somewhat of a mission-style design, very mission-style table. It's not going to be a huge table, just enough for 4 people. Basically, you know what I used to size the table? I took our current outdoor patio table that I have in my dining room that we've been using. I took those proportions and then figured out how we actually play the board game Sorry on it. I can't really reach to the other side easily. My wife can't reach to my side easily. So that tells me I need to make the table a little bit more narrow so we can play Sorry. And of course, you know, we'll eat at the table too. So I started out with a mission style design, and then I kind of shifted over a couple different design changes into like a trestle table, and then added some more curves to the trestle table, and then did a through tusk tenon on the main trestle part of the table. And it was just, I'm so indecisive. Then I went back to the mission style design, and that's kind of where I'm at. So who knows what you guys will see once I end up starting to make it, but I think I'm just kind of like brain overload with this. I'm overthinking it, and I just need to start the project, so or take a break from it. So what I'm going to do, I think, is I'm going to leave this stuff, all this Hickory, in my way so I do get the project done, but I think I'm going to take a couple days break from this and then make something else that will kind of keep my mind at ease or whatever. Like a mallet or two, make a couple mallets. I want to give a couple mallets as gifts to a couple people, so that'd be a good opportunity to knock those projects out really quick, and then also take a break from this. So the beginning of this table probably won't be this week, but it'll be the following week's video. And I think it's gonna be a couple different videos. If I make breadboard ends on the tabletop, then it'll probably be broken down into 2 videos. If I don't do the breadboard ends, then I'll probably just do the entire video or entire project in 1 video, minus the finish, which I'm working on maybe another collaboration with the finish on the project. So But the base, if I go with the mission style base, it's going to be just a ton of mortises. So, yeah, that won't be too long of a project if I do it that route, because you just set up the operation and batch out every one of those particular mortises and tenons that are sized for that particular joint. So, anyway, when I get to that, it should definitely be fun. Got a couple of cool things in the mail this week. A Tigers flag. I got the Red Wings and the Lions and the Tigers now flag for here in the shop. Thank you very much, Joel. I appreciate that, Joel from Tecumseh, Michigan. That was very, very kind of you. That was his office flag that he's had in his office for a while, and now it's here in the shop. So thank you very much. I do appreciate that. I will admit, though, I'm not a huge fan of baseball, like hardly at all, but the Detroit Tigers, just the whole Detroit Tigers D, that's just so iconic of Detroit. But anyway, thank you very much for that. It's very kind of you. I do appreciate it. And also, Andrew Latham sent my Tool Talk video on my planer, sent me, man, I'm not working with this tripod too well today, sent me the infeed and outfeed tables for it. And then also I put also sent me another set of blades, which very much appreciated. I was actually about to buy another set. And then put this elbow on here, this street elbow. And then I have the hose going off to one side like I normally do. This is the 4-inch sewer and drain PVC elbow. I think it's called a street elbow, to where the side that attaches to the planer is actually able to fit inside of another fitting. And then the other side of that elbow is the normal size of an elbow, and then the hose fits inside it. So this particular thing is just a nice, perfect, snug fit, and I should have done that earlier. So I appreciate that. Thank you very much for the infeed and outfeed tables and the blades as well. You guys are so awesome and kind. I need to do a giveaway. So many people have sent me some awesome stuff. I need to do a giveaway here soon to kind of keep the paying it forward snowball going. So that's it. Don't really have anything else to talk about other than stickers. The whole sticker snowball trend is still moving forward with ease. So I got a bunch of stickers to put up on the small rolling tool cabinet, but I think I will do that outside in the driveway because it's a beautiful day outside and I want to use my just dead sexy work truck as a backdrop. So you guys take care and I'll talk to you next week.